Hello, Rewinders, Dallas and
Celeste. We are here to give you our review of 2020's Mulan for our backlog golf because we wanted to watch it.
Yeah, absolutely. And we need those points back.
We need those points back.
Or deducted, however this works out. So, if you're unfamiliar with 2020's Mulan, it's about a young Chinese maiden who disguises herself as a man to go into war to protect her father. It was written by Niki Caro, who also did The Zookeeper's Wife, and was written by Rick Jaffa, who did the most recent Planet of the Apes films.
Now, this movie also had a fairly large cast, including Li Gong as I'm not sure how to say her name, but she was the Falcon.
Yes.
And then
she's from Memoirs of a Geisha.
She is from Memoirs of a Geisha. And then also Jet Li from any number of things, but predominantly Once Upon a Time in China.
Not predominantly, but there's a reason why we're putting that out there. Wink, wink, Mr. Francisco. Also starring Donnie Yen, who is Mr. Ip Man himself, and also Yifei Liu, or Yifei, I don't know, someone help me out with that.
We're not sure.
So, who plays Mulan specifically, but she was also in several movies, such as The Forbidden Kingdom, which I really enjoyed, which also might be mentioned later.
Was Jet Li in that one as well?
He was. And Jackie Chan.
Oh, how have I not seen that yet?
Backlog golf continues. So let's give us some trivia about the film.
Well, the trivia tends to wait till the end.
Okay, let's wait with that. We want to do our classic makers?
I want to do our classic makers.
What's your classic maker?
My classic maker is the fact of the writing.
Yeah?
The story. They did not imitate the movie. They took the original legend and went, okay, how do we make a live action of this?
Mm-hmm.
Instead of going, let's make a shot for shot of the cartoon.
Yeah, I appreciate that because that's something Disney's been failing at lately. My classic maker...
Look at you, okay.
Oof. My classic maker is actually the cast. I appreciate that it's a star-studded cast of people that I think a lot of Americans may not recognize because they are massive stars in China and other Asian films. Like, if you go through the IMDb, these guys have done a ton of stuff that I feel fortunate to have been able to watch because they're such good films. I want to encourage you guys to go to IMDb, check out these actors, and check out the other films they did because they're great films. Absolutely great. So what's your tragic maker?
Ooh, well, it's a hard one.
Okay. Want me to tell mine first?
Yes, please.
There's no Mushu.
That was what I was trying to not say.
Okay, that's our tragic maker.
That's our tragic maker.
No Mushu.
Miss Mushu. Eddie Murphy, where are you?
So, I mean, it works because they're going for a more serious tone, and I understand and I appreciate it. There's some allusions to Mushu.
Yeah, there's a few.
And this whole phoenix thing was interesting, although I was kind of confused, like, is the phoenix real? Like, did other people see the phoenix in these scenes or not? I wasn't sure, but...
Is she hallucinating?
Maybe.
Drink a little bit too much of the green tea?
Awkward. So, but that's my treasure maker. That was yours.
Yeah.
So, all right.
I was trying to not say that. That's why I paused, because I was like, I just missed Mushu.
All right, so.
Okay, what is our... Do we do final rating and then...
No, trivia, then final rating.
Trivia, then final rating.
All right.
Okay, so the little bit of trivia. Per IMDb. Let me see if I can get past it. Oh, here it is. So, actor and martial artist Jet Li, who played the Emperor, like we said, admitted that he turned down the role at first because of the script and the pay.
Oh.
His daughters went no. And they reminded him that it was important for Disney to shine a light on Chinese culture. So he backtracked and went, okay, I'll do it.
That's cool.
So win for the daughters because we loved seeing Jet Li.
To be fair, at the same time, he did say several years ago that he was done doing Chinese period pieces. So that was some of it.
I'm sure it was.
Yeah.
But... I mean, it's Jet Li.
Yeah, it's Jet Li. Dude's a beast. I love his films.
Pretty sure. So, also, random side note, the girl who played Mulan did 90% of her own stunts.
Oh, wow, that's amazing. That's pretty cool.
I thought that was pretty impressive.
Yep. Also, the actress who actually voiced Mulan in the original movie makes an appearance.
In a dress very similar to how they have Mulan dressed.
Fascinating stuff.
Not the live-action Mulan, but the...
Yeah.
The Mulan she played.
Yeah. All right, Celeste. So, how do we rate this? Classic? classic, nostalgic, or tragic?
I'm gonna say it's gonna be a classic. I think if you enjoy martial arts movies, especially the type that where they're doing crazy things like running on the sides of walls, mm-hmm. you will really enjoy this. It's a good movie. It's yeah. not dumbed down. The only thing that I would say that would be it makes it more family friendly mm-hmm. is there's no blood.
Yeah, pretty much blood free. I'm gonna agree. Classic, especially if you're into Chinese films and Chinese martial arts films. A lot of them have been put in there. Disney, I think, did a great job honoring some of the techniques of Chinese martial arts films. So, all right, so that's our ratings. Love to hear your guys' thoughts. Leave comments down below. Don't forget to make sure you follow Retro Rewind Podcast on your favorite podcast catcher. Check out their Twitch streams, Retro Rewind Pod on twitch.tv. And check out the Facebook. There's a YouTube thing. Fresco's is doing stuff. He's doing lots of stuff. Him and Paul. Just
and,
crazy.
And also, if you want to be part of our backlog golf, join the Discord.
Yes. So, until next time.
Stay devoted.
Peace and love.
That's not how they end that.